SWISH, selling with integrity and selling honestly. Like, I love being in, when I go places, the first probably two-thirds of my life, I spent scrounging, kind of trying to, we talked about this, trying to manage things. And about 10 years ago, I decided, hey, look, this isn't working. I'm just always trying to get by. And I literally made a decision. I read this thing that Aristotle Onassis, I don't know, you probably don't know who that was, but he was a Greek shipping tycoon. And Jacqueline Onassis,
yes,
that was Kennedy's wife, married him after John Kennedy died. He was extremely wealthy. He would only drink coffee. He had this thing. He would only drink coffee at the most expensive places. And when I read that, I'm like, I've been drinking coffee at the cheapest places, right? Now we got Starbucks where it's not cheap, but people are just hanging out there. But the point of that story is to hang out with people are doing well and want to do well. So we stayed at the Park Hyatt in Sydney. There was all this wealth around us. And
this way you said proximity to power.
Proximity, man. Be as close as you can to the vibration. Like, even if you can't meet the people. Like, when I changed my basis from staying in a Four Seasons as opposed to staying at the Holiday Inn. No offense to the Holiday Inn, okay? I'm not endorsing Four Seasons, but you know, when you're staying at a place where breakfast is free, and that's when people are going there because breakfast is free and an upgrade and awards and points, the intention of the family going there is different than the intention of the guy or the gal, the executives that are going to the Four Seasons and paying another $600 a night.
For sure.
One's wanting to do business and expand, and the other's trying to have a moment for their phones and their Facebook of memories. And that's great and everything, but everything's done on a budget over here. And these people over here are thinking about opportunity rather than budget. That changed my whole life 10 years ago.
For sure. And how would you, the flip side of that then, because when I read 10X Rule, I started to think like that. I surround myself with different people. I started to think bigger. Then the people that are around you, and I think I know what you're going to say here, would suggest that then you're faking it till you make it.
Like, what's no, I'm not fake. You can't fake staying at the Park Hyatt. I mean, the rooms are, I think the room is $3,200 a night. You can't fake that. I mean, you can either pay for it or you can't pay for it. So you're not going to get in faking that. Now, you know, the fake it till you make it thing, like, I think if you fake it till you make it, you know, people are taking that out of context and taking pictures in front of Lambos and private jets rather than saying, wait a minute, I need to show up every day. Fake it till you make it means you got to show up and act like your business is doing well if it's not. And keep showing up like it's doing well if you're not. To me, fake it if you make it means you just called on six people and all six said no. You need to walk into the seventh one like you closed all the first six.
Yeah, I love it.
That's fake it till you make it. Anything short of that, like you're wearing a fake Rolex or you're buying an Hermes belt trying to show off or you're buying $2,800 shoes that you can't afford. You paid for them, but you can't afford them. That's faking it till you. That's faking it too, and that's not a good fake because nobody's going to do business with you because of your belt, your shoes, the car you drove up in. There's a lot of that going on today,
yes, for sure.
Where people are, they're spending money they probably shouldn't be, rather than making calls they should be.
Yeah, I love it.